Today, I'm going to start with the new unit, that is Unit 3, that is Fiction. So, आप लोगों ने बचपन से पढ़ा होगा फिक्शन क्या है, नॉवेल क्या है, फिक्शन क्या होता है, कल्पना होती है. सो दिस वर्ड फिक्शन, वेर हैज इट डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम? इट हैज बीन डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम अ लैटिन वर्ड व्हिच इज नोन एज फिक्टस, FICTUS. एंड दिस वर्ड, लैटिन वर्ड मींस टू फॉर्म, किसी चीज को बनाना. समबडी हैज ब्यूटिफुली डिफाइंड दिस वर्ड फिक्शन एज literature in the form of prose, especially novels that describes imaginary events and people. Imaginary means काल्पनिक, ऐसे events जो हम सिर्फ कल्पना करते हैं, उसको हम form करते हैं, उसको बनाते हैं, और लोग. It is a form of prose, especially novels that describes imaginary events and people. And yes, fiction may be defined as any imaginative recreation of life. In which form? In a prose narrative form. And all fiction is actually a falsehood of elements, of events. Why? Because it relates events that never actually happened to people, that never actually happened to the characters, who never even existed, and not in a manner portrayed in the stories. So, fiction, jo fiction likhte hain, the aim of the writers who write fiction is to create legitimate untruths. Legitimate untruths. So this is a word which I am giving you, that the writers of these fiction people, fiction novels, they aim at creating the legitimate untruths. And since they seek to demonstrate meaningful insights into the human condition, therefore, we can emphatically say that fiction is untrue in the absolute sense, but true in the universal sense. And yes, novel is a prominent form of fiction. The novel is only one of many possible prose narrative forms, which shares with other narratives as well, like the epic, the romance, and the two basic characteristics, that is a story and a storyteller. Ek kahani aur ek kahani batane wala. And you know, the germs of this novel, iski upaj kahan se hui? It lay in the medieval romance, a fantastic tale of love and adventure, which is actually deprived from the songs, the ballads, and the epic poems. The epic. What is the epic? I told you that day also. It is a traditional story and is a blending of myth, history, fiction. And who are their heroes? Gods and goddesses. Extraordinary men of power, men and women of national importance. And the romance also tells stories of larger than life characters. And these characters, they emphasize adventure and often involves a quest for an ideal. The events may be dreams, may be myths or rituals. The novel can possess all these things, but the difference lies in the realistic treatment of life and manners. Its heroes are men and women like ourselves. So we can say that the novel was a product of an intellectual milieu shaped by the great 17th century writers. The novel individualized its characters by locating them precisely in time, in space, and the subjects and its subjects are reflected the popular 18th century concern with the social adventures or the structures of everyday life going on. You must be knowing that the novel is said to have emerged with the appearance of Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe, 1719, and Moll Flanders, 1722. And these novels are picaresque stories. Picaresque ka matlab hota hai rogue, R-O-G-U-E. The stories where the main character is a rogue. And in these picaresque stories, there is always a sequence of episodes which are held together tightly because they happen to one single person. But the central character in both these novels, the central character, jo main hota hai, that is so convincing and specific that Daniel Defoe is sometimes credited with being the first writer of the realistic fiction. Kehne ko to wo kalpana hai, lekin is tarike se wo woven hota hai, is tarike se uska presentation hota hai, that it seems to be like a realistic fiction. The first novel of character or psychological novel is Samuel Richardson's Pamela, which is an epistolary novel. Epistolary novel ka matlab hota hai novel written in letters, letter form, exchange of letters. And it is a work which is characterized by the beautiful plotting of the emotional bent of mind, the emotional states of the protagonist. Defoe and Richardson are undoubtedly the first great writers in our literature who did not take their plots from mythology, from history, from legends, or from any previous literature. And they established the novel's claim as an authentic account of the actual experiences of the individuals. Unka khud ka experience, not taking anything from anywhere. And reasons for the novel's popularity in the 18th century, particularly in the Victorian period, the novel is being replaced by the poetry and drama and became one of the most popular literary forms because it was closely associated or closely representing the lives of the majority of people. And it also became popular because the social scope expanded to include characters and stories about the middle class and the working class. जब भी हम working class या middle class या mass की बात करेंगे और उनके emotions को हम कहीं न कहीं पेज पे लाएंगे, it actually has to hit. Like that of the spectator, those spectators जो हमने आपको बताया था, Tatler spectator, and they also created that level where everybody was fond of reading that. And because of this, the readership increased and the large number of percentage were women, servants, and people, the masses. This genre, the novel, became the form which most addressed the domestic and the social concerns of these group of people. So this, in short, is a beautiful understanding of a novel, or you can say fiction. Now, there are many types of novel. जैसे हर जार में, पोइट्री में, ड्रामा में, नॉन फिक्शन में, फिक्शन में, सभी में देर आर सो मेनी टाइप्स एंड दीज टाइप्स हेल्प अस टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंशिएशन, द डिफरेंस ऑफ द डिफरेंट नॉवेल्स और द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ नॉवेल्स विच आर रिटन बाय सो मेनी राइटर्स इन ऑल ओवर द एजेस. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द रियलिस्टिक नॉवेल. What is realistic novel? It is sometimes called also the novel of manners. These realistic novels are known for their complex characters, and they have mixed motives rooted in a social class and operate according to the highly developed social structure. For example, there are two realistic novels. For example, I'll give you here 13 Reasons Why by Jay Asher, J-A-Y-A-S-H-E-R. And the second realistic novel, for example, is Looking for Alaska. Looking for Alaska. And this is written by John Green. The second bifurcation in this term novel is the PKRX novel, which I told you also. These are the novels which relates the adventures of the hero in the episodic form, and the name PKRX has been taken from the Spanish word picaro, which means rogue. You must be knowing these novels. Rudyard Kipling's Kim is a PKRX novel, which was written in 1901. And Henry Fielding's The Story of Tom Jones, 1749. Then next is the historical novel. A historical novel is a novel set in a period earlier than that of writing. Suppose करिए हम आज novel लिख रहे हैं, लेकिन ये novel जो हम आज लिख रहे हैं ये पहले set है. जैसे for example Thackeray's Vanity Fair, Charles Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities. These are good examples of historical novel. Then epistolary novel, the most popular genre, a series of documents again. And this word epistolary, this comes from the Latin where epistola means a letter. इसीलिए इसको कहते हैं a novel which is written in the form of letters. Example, Pamela and Clarissa by Samuel Richardson and Alice Walker. Alice Walker की एक epistolary novel है जिसका नाम है The Color Purple. The Color Purple. And एक novelist है उसका नाम है Bram Stoker. The novel name is Dracula. Dracula. And one more name I would tell you, Bridget Jones. Bridget, B-R-I-D-G-E-T, J-O-N-E-S. उसके novel का नाम है epistolary diary, D-I-A-R-Y, diary. Clear? Now, there is another type of novel known as Gothic novel. Gothic novel is a novel which includes terror, mystery, thriller, supernatural elements, death, decay, haunted buildings, ghosts, omens, and so on. The best example would be Mary Shelley's Frankenstein and Bram Stoker's Dracula, which is also a Gothic novel. Then Horace Walpole's The Castle of Otranto. Now, we will discuss autobiographical novel. Very simple. It is a novel based on the life of the author himself. Charles Dickens, David Copperfield, Great Expectations, D.H. Lawrence, Sons and Lovers, Sylvia Plath's The Bell Jar, Ralph Ellison's Invisible Man, Maya Angelou, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, and Virginia Woolf, To the Lighthouse. All these names are very popular, very important for your examination, and the internal story as well as the characters are to be read by you for all these names which I have taken.